Dan said probably three or four times really loud, prayer changes things, prayer changes things. And then Ryan just said it too, so I think we have our confirmation that prayer changes things. Okay. So anyway, I'm kind of a simple, practical person, so I wanted to give a couple of suggestions if you're a mother, or even if you're not a mother, praying for other people's children too. So the first thing that we can do is you personally, as a mother or a parent, a father, you seek the Lord with your whole heart. Amen. Seek the Lord with your whole heart. Second, be a Christ-like example. Not just what you say, but what you do, because they're watching you.
Amen.
Third, don't try to fix them. And right here, I'm not practicing what I preach. Because my husband will say, quit trying to fix your son. Okay. All right. So, shoot me. Okay. So, anyway. But I'm learning that prayer is the only thing that really works. And I think most of the rest of you have probably figured it out. I'm kind of a slow learner. Spend a lot of time on your knees praying for your children and your grandchildren. And fourth, the enemy wants to tell you to give up. He's always going to tell you God's not listening, or it's not working, or that your child's never going to change, they're never going to do this or that, or get saved. Don't listen to them, because any negative thing like that's not from the Lord. So you know it's from the enemy, so it's a big lie. So, with that, I'll read my poem here. You ask me to speak of being a mother. I tell you, it's a ministry like no other. Sometimes a joyous and rewarding plight, but sometimes it keeps you up all night. To say a prayer and dry a tear, to say, come to me, baby, mama's right here. Mama, the one with fears of her own, who won't stop fretting even after you're grown. But God hears my prayers and counts my tears. He gives me peace with my mama fears. He comes to me in sleepless nights and says, your baby's going to be all right. The peace of God will see me through, because he loves my baby more than I do. So the days go by, and as you grow, precious memories we do sow. Days of playing in the sun, storybooks when the day is done. Until you grow up and start to pull away, but mama tries to hang on tight anyway. No more tears to dry, no more games to play. Has your childhood really slipped away? So with you all grown up at a second glance, grandbabies are my second chance. To do it perfect, no regrets, but I fear that hasn't happened yet. So I worry about them just like I did you. What can a loving mother do? She must rest in the Lord, and when it comes to her babies, maybe she'll get a good night's sleep tonight. Maybe, just maybe.